So today lecture topic is salient characters of subcumulum protozoa. Protozoa is a subkingdom, comes under the class, come under the kingdom Protista. So today we will discuss about the salient character of subkingdom Protozoa. So parasite, I have already discussed many times. Parasite divide into mainly three groups: helminth parasite, arthropods parasite. Helminth and arthropods are multicellular, means metazoan parasite. Here is protozoa. Protozoa is a unicellular parasite. So today I will discuss about some general character of protozoa. So this is the simple classification of subkingdom Protozoa. Protozoa comes under the kingdom Protista, and subkingdom Protozoa divided into three subphyla: Sarcomastigophora, Apicomplexa, Microspora, and Ciliophora. Ciliophora. Then, phylum Sarcomastigophora consists of four family: Trypanosomidae family, mainly Trypanosoma and Leishmania. Protozoan parasites come under the Trypanosomidae family, Monosarcomonidae family, Trichomonidae family, and Entamoebidae family. In Entamoebidae family, Entamoeba genus or Entamoeba protozoan parasite mainly is a genotic protozoan parasite comes under. Then second phylum is another important protozoan phylum which contains more family in comparison to phylum Sarcomastigophora. This contains Hemogregorinidae family, Emeridae family contains important gastrointestinal protozoan parasite Emeria. Emeria is an important protozoan parasite in case of poultry industries. Then Cryptosporidae, Sarcocystidae, Toxoplasmodi, Plasmodidae, Mavesidae, and Thaliridae are three important hemoprotozoan parasite. Mavesidae contain Mavesia species, Thaliridae contain Thaliria species, and Plasmodia species contain Plasmodium species. These are three important hemoprotozoan parasite which found mainly blood of the infected host. Then phylum Microspora, then phylum Ciliophora. Phylum Ciliophora contain one important family is Blentidae. That is Blentidium coli is a protozoan parasite. This is genotic protozoan parasite. So this is simple classification of subkingdom Protozoa. We have read detailed classification in protozoology unit. Then I come to about the characters. So first, protozoa was discovered by Antoine Leeuwenhoek, A.V. Leeuwenhoek. That scientist also called father of protozoology. Protozoa were discovered by Leeuwenhoek. That is also called father of protozoology. Protozoa, proto means first, zoon means animal. So first animal life which appear on this earth belong to this category. Protozoa were divided, consist of two parts. Proto means first, zoon means animal. So first animal life which appear on this earth belong to protozoan category. As I have told, protozoa is a unicellular parasite, mainly microscopic, mostly microscopic. We cannot see with naked eye. And eukaryotic organism means it has well-defined nucleus, where bacteria is a prokaryotic organism. Protozoa is a unicellular, mostly microscopic, and eukaryotic organism means it has distinct nucleus enclosed in a nuclear membrane. Then, body of the protozoa divided into two parts, that is cytoplasm and nucleus. This is nucleus and this is the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm divided into two parts, ectoplasm, that is outer cytoplasm, and endoplasm, granule endoplasm, which contain mainly organelles. And both ectoplasm and endoplasm comes under cytoplasm. And then nucleus is two types, nucleus vesicular and compact carpel nucleus found in case of protozoa. Then food vacuoles, which help in digestion of the foods, and contractile vacuoles mainly help in excretion, that is osmoregulatory function. This is pseudopodia. Some protozoa have pseudopodia. Pseudopodia is a locomotory organ as well as help in ingestion of food. Also, pseudopodia is also called false food or temporary locomotory organ. So this is contractile vacuole, mainly help in the excretion of the waste materials by the osmoregulatory function. And this is food vacuoles, help in the digestion of food. Then movement of protozoa. Protozoa moved by pseudopodia, have locomotory organs, pseudopodia. Some protozoa have locomotory organs, pseudopodia. Some protozoa have locomotory flagella, some have cilia, and some protozoa have absent of locomotory organs. So movement of protozoa occurs in those protozoan parasites, which means locomotory organ absent, move through gliding. Gliding means sarakna. So protozoa ka movement pseudopodia ke dwara hota hai, ya either flagella, cilia, or through gliding movement. This is the pseudopodia, this is the ciliated structure, a small hair-like structure, this is the flagella, flagellate thread-like structure. This protozoa movement by the pseudopodia. Pseudopodia movement mainly occurs in intermeva histolytica. This is the genotic protozoan, gastrointestinal protozoan parasite, intermeva genus. Mainly gastrointestinal tract mein milta hai. Ye genotic hai kyunki man aur animal dono ko infect karta hai. So intermeva histolytica mein movement pseudopodia ke dwara aata. Pseudopodia is also called false food, or it is also a temporary locomotory organ. Form as per need. Jab jarurat hota hai, tabhi banata hai organism. So pseudopodia is a temporary locomotory organs and also help in ingestion of food. Then some protozoa moves through with the help of flagella, like Trichomonas organism. Various Trichomonas organism, Trichomonas fetus in case of animal is important protozoan parasite, which cause early abortions. This is the Trypanosoma species. This is the flagella. This is the Giardia. This is also a gastrointestinal protozoan, genotic protozoan parasite. This is the flagella and Leishmania. Leishmania donovani, Leishmania tropica. This also has flagella and help in the movement of the movement in the organism. So these all organism, Trypomonas, Trypanosoma, Giardia, Leishmania have flagella which help in movement. Then some protozoa use cilia for the movement. That example is Blantidium coli. This is the Blantidium coli. Trophozoite assay, generally Blantidium coli gastroenterite have two stages, trophozoite stages and cystic stages. Cystic stages generally form outside the host. Usually form outside the host. This is the trophozoite stage, usually form inside the host. The trophozoite stage have ciliate, body has ciliated structure, so and help in the movement of the Blantidium coli. Blantidium coli had two type of nucleus, micronucleus, this is a small nucleus, and this is large nucleus, that is macronucleus. This is the cytostome which help in ingestion of food. This is the cytopyrene which help in excretion of the waste material, found in case of Blantidium coli. Then those protozoa which have no locomotory organs move by gliding movement. Gliding means sarakna. So many protozoa have no locomotory organs and movement through the gliding movement, like Toxoplasma, Sarcocystic, Cimmeria, Isospora, Hepatozoon, Thaleria, Babesia, Plasmodium, Hemoproteus, Leucocytogen species. These all move through gliding because these protozoan parasite have no locomotory organ, absence of locomotory organ. Then come to nutrition. Nutrition of protozoa. They are. Some protozoa have holophytic, some have holozoic, some protozoa have saprozoic nutrition. So saprozoic protozoa, mainly parasitic protozoa, have saprozoic type of nutrition, means soluble nutrients cross the plasma membrane of protozoa by pinocytosis, formation of vesicle, and enter inside the body of the protozoa. So saprozoic protozoa, in case of saprozoic nutrition, protozoa use soluble nutrient that have pre-digested nutrient and cross the plasma membrane by pinocytosis, diffusion, or carrier-mediated transport. Then some protozoa have holophytic type of nutrition, means have chromatophore, have chlorophylls, which prepare the food by the photosynthesis method. So some protozoa have holophytic nutrition and some holozoic nutritions, and which use pseudopodia for the ingestion of capturing of the food. Then food goes through food vacuole, and inside the food vacuole digestion of the food particle occurs, and excretion of the or metabolic waste product and digestion material excreted through the surface membrane and body covering of the protozoan. And as contractile vacuoles, I have told, help in the excretion of the digested material or waste material which has osmolarity function. Then important aspect that is reproduction in protozoa. So generally asexual reproduction or sexual reproduction occurs in some protozoa have asexual reproduction, and some protozoa have both asexual and sexual method of reproduction occurs. So various type of asexual reproduction occur, that is binary fission, zygogony means multiple fission, then budding and sporogony. This is the asexual type of reproduction. Then sexual type of reproduction is syngamy and conjugation. Some of the protozoa use only asexual method of reproduction, and some of the protozoa use both asexual and sexual method of reproduction. This is the asexual method of reproduction, that is most common is binary fission. Through this, most of the protozoa reproduce. In this first nucleus divide, then cytoplasmic division occurs, and both parts separate and backside individual organism. This is the longitudinal binary fission, in which longitudinal division of organism occurs. In case of transverse binary fission, transverse division of organism occurs. Transverse binary fission mainly occurs in case of Blantidium coli that have cilia. So transverse binary fission mainly found in case of Blantidium coli. Then another asexual method of reproduction is multiple fission, means nucleus divides many times. First nucleus divides many times, then in each nucleus takes some cytoplasm and behave as an individual organism. Then this is the zygote stage. Zygote nucleus divides many times by zygogeny and multiple fission. This is no individual organism. Then zygote ruptures and an individual merozoite, individual organism release. So by the division of the zygote nucleus, many merozoite develop by the process of zygogony or multiple fission. Then budding, two or more daughter form are produced from the parent cells and grow individual. Two type of budding occurs, endodiogenic means internal budding. Endodio means two daughter cells are formed within the parent cells, and endopolygenic is many daughter cells are formed within the parent cells. Endopolygenic is occurs in toxoplasma and sarcocystic species of protozoan parasite. Both are zoonotic protozoan parasite. Male. So both infect also male. So toxoplasma and sarcocystic organism reproduced by the endopolygeny method of budding. Then sexual method of reproduction is first is conjugation, in which exchange of nuclear material of micronucleus. There are two type of nucleus we have discussed in detail in protozoology section 2 time, micronucleus and macronucleus. Micronucleus help in the reproduction and macronucleus help in cytoplasmic activity of the protozoa parasite. So exchange of nuclear material from the micronucleus takes place due to micronucleus help in reproduction, and this is mainly found conjugation in ciliate. You have already known in paramecium conjugation occurs. And in case of Blantidium coli, in case of animal protozoan parasite, Blantidium coli reproduced by the conjugation. Then another common method of sexual reproduction is syngamy, means forming in this process two gametes are formed, that is male gamete and female gamete. Both gametes are fused to form a zygote. Then zygote develop to individual protozoan parasite. In some protozoa have two similar gametes are formed, then fused, then known as isogamy. In case of some protozoa have two dissimilar gametes are formed, that is known as anisogamy, and fusion is known as anisogamy. In isogamy, a smaller gamete is known as male gamete, that is microgamete, which is formed from microgametocyte. And larger gamete is known as female gamete, that is macrogamete, and produced from macrogametocyte. So in case of syngamete, fusion of two gamete occurs to form zygote. In conjugation process, exchange of nuclear material takes place from the micronucleus, and then individual organism separate. Then after a syngamete, another asexual method of reproduction occurs in some protozoan parasite, that is a sporogony. A sporogony is asexual process of multiple fission, normally follows syngamy, means syngamy ke baad, zygote ke baad, a sporogony method of asexual reproduction hota hai. In a sporogony, zygote form in number of sporozoite within the ball of seed. A sporozoite is the infective stage in many protozoan parasite. A sporozoite is the infective stage in many protozoan parasite. A sporozoite is formed by the process of a sporogony method of asexual reproduction. Then life cycle of protozoa, there are usually indirect life cycles, but some protozoa have direct life cycle. In case of direct life cycle, Blantidia coli, Giardia, Entamoeba, Trichomonas species have direct life cycles. No intermediate host involved to complete the life cycle of protozoan parasite. This is the indirect life cycle. In case of Babesia species require tick vector to complete the life cycle, because some stages of the Babesia develop inside the ticks. And as sporozoite infective stages develop inside the ticks, as sporozoite inoculated inside the hood during the blood sucking. So Babesia have indirect life cycle. Then another important hemoprotozoan parasite have indirect, that is Thalaria species. Thalaria species have required tick vector to complete the life cycle. And a sporozoite like Babesia is inoculated inside the host by the tick during blood sucking. So a sporozoite and zygote develop inside the tick. Then some protozoa have direct life cycle, that like Trichomonas fetus. Trichomonas fetus is an important protozoan parasite, is found in the reproductive organ of the animals and is caused important disease, abortion, early abortion before 6 months of pregnancy. So it causes early abortion, have direct life cycle. This is a trophozoite phase. Trophozoite stage is transmitted during the copulation from the infected bull to cow and cow to bull, because protozoan parasite found in the reproductive tract of cow and bull. So transmission occurs through venereal transmission, occurs during copulation. Another protozoa have direct life cycle, that is Giardia. Giardia is a genotic protozoan parasite found in gastrointestinal tract of man, dog. From the infected host, cystic stage, two stages are found in life cycle of Giardia, that is trophozoite stage and cystic stage. Trophozoite stage found mainly inside the host, and cystic stage is secreted through the feces of the infected host. Cystic is the protective stage, protect from unfavorable environment. Final host get infection by the ingestion of cystic contaminated feed and butter. So no intermediate host or vector involved in the life cycle of Giardia protozoan parasite. So these have direct life cycle. So protozoan parasite have some protozoa have direct life cycle, but most of the protozoa have indirect life cycle. So indirect life cycle have vector, require vector to complete their life cycle. Then come to some example, some important protozoan parasite, hemoprotozoa. This is the example of hemoprotozoan parasite. It's the common hemoprotozoan parasite and economical hemoprotozoan parasite, because infection leads to decreased milk production, animal health, even death of the infected animals, and ultimately loss of the economical loss of the owner. So Trypanosoma abhisa is important hemoprotozoan parasite, cause important disease trypanosomiasis or SARA. By Babesia, many Babesia species, one of the important Babesia species found in case of cow is cattle is Babesia bijemina, cause babesiosis disease and red water disease in which coffee color urine, that is hemoglobinuria, occurs in case of babesiosis. So urine become red and coffee color urine is created through the infected animal. In case of Theileria annulata, also Theileria have many species, important species which I found in India is Theileria annulata, called is bovine tropical theileriosis. This is the Theileria species. This is the ring separate signature inside the RBC. This is the RBC. This is the a small organism that is known as Theileria pyroplasma stage. This is the Babesia organism inside the RBC. This is the Trypanosoma species. Trypanosoma is an extracellular parasite found in the blood plasma outside the blood cells. This is the Theileria and Babesia is intracellular organism found inside the RBC. This is the dot separate, look like dot separate. This is the Theileria organism. Another is Hepatozoon canis. Canis is found in the capsule separate, elongated separate, found in neutrophil, inside the neutrophil. This is the neutrophil and found inside the neutrophil, gametocyte stage of Hepatozoon canis. This is the example, some important example of gastrointestinal protozoan parasite, Emeria species, cause disease known as coccidiosis. Coccidiosis is mainly important in case of poultry because it's got motility in chicks, heavy motility in chicks. Entamoeba histolytica is a genotic, gastrointestinal genotic protozoan parasite, cause amoebic dysentery. And Giardia is caused disease giardiosis, and Toxoplasma gondii is also a genotic gastrointestinal protozoan parasite causing toxoplasmosis. Cryptosporidia is also a gastrointestinal protozoan parasite causing cryptosporidiosis. This is the oocyst of Emeria. This is the Giardia species. This is the flagella. This is the oocyst of the Cryptosporidia. Oocyst of the Cryptosporidia. So these all about the subkingdom protozoa. Protozoa is a important point of protozoa. Protozoa is unicellular and eukaryotic organism. Protozoa is a unicellular and eukaryotic organism because eukaryotic because it has well defined nucleus. Protozoa is a unicellular one celled organism, and protozoa first discovered by Leeuwenhoek. Movement in protozoa by cilia, flagella, pseudopodia, or by gliding movement. Nutrition of protozoa is holophytic, holozoic, and saprozoic type of nutrition. Then reproduction of protozoa is asexual reproduction. Asexual method of reproduction is binary fission, multiple fission, that is cyzogony, budding asporogony. Then sexual reproduction is conjugation and syngamy. In syngamy, mainly two gamete fuse to form zygote. Then asporogony is a asexual method of reproduction occurs after the syngamy. Syngamy ke baad asporogony hota hai, jisme zygote division hoke asporozoite banata hai. Asporozoite is the infective stage of many protozoan parasite. Then life cycle is mainly indirect, involve require intermediate host or vector to complete the life cycle, but some protozoa have direct life cycle like Giardia, Tritrichomonas, Sclerotica have direct life cycle, no intermediate host or vector required to complete the life cycle. Some of the important protozoan parasites: Trypanosoma abelsai, Babesia pyogenina, Theleria nullata, Hepatozoan casein, Leishmania donovan, all are hemoprotozoan parasites found inside the blood of the infected host. Then some of the gastrointestinal protozoan parasites like Emeria, Entamoeba scleritica, Giardia, Toxoplasma gondii, Cryptosporidia is a gastrointestinal protozoan parasite found in the gastrointestinal tract of the infected animal. So this is all about the protozoan